and welcome to my channel. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. So right now, the concept which I'm going to talk about, it is one of the 4-mark question, that is legal definition of money. So as I'm continuously doing with the money related topic, so you are aware this is one of the topic of money and banking chapter, macroeconomics 3rd chapter. So in this one, the question demands, please do explain the legal definitions of money. So when it comes to legal definition, we can classify that into 4 types or 4 different way. One is M1, money definition, which is 2, money definition 3, money definition 4. Let's talk about individually now. The first one, M1, which is money definition 1, it talks about CU plus DD. If you're going to add CU plus DD, then it will be called as money definition, which is 1. So what is the CU meaning? The C is currency held by the public. The public being a public, how much money you're holding in your hand. So that money is called CU, which is currency held by the public. On the second one, DD, which is net demand deposits held by the commercial banks. Net demand deposits held by the commercial banks, that means how much deposit we have kept in the commercial bank, not that where inter-commercial banking transaction, if it is there, that we are not going to count, that will be excluded. Only the public deposit, what they have kept in the commercial bank, only that will be counted. So that's the reason why we are talking about like net demand deposits held by commercial banks. So then, by adding this, if you're going to consider money what you have in the public hand and the commercial hand, in the commercial banks, how much money, how much deposits we have, on the basis of that, that will be called as M1, the first definition. On the other side, you have the second definition, which is M2. To consider this M2, first of all, you have to consider M1 again. M1, that means CU plus DD. That way also you can take it as CU plus DD plus POSPD. So POSPD is Post Office Saving Bank with the saving deposits. In the post office, whatever the savings we have done, so that will be counted with CU plus DD plus POSPD. All the 3 if you are going to consider, then it will become M2. Otherwise, in short, you can even go with M1 plus POSPD indirectly. M1 is nothing but CU plus DD. So otherwise, you can go with like CU plus DD plus POSPD. It's one of the same. Then, the third definition what you have, that is M3, where M1 plus TD, that is M1 plus TD. Again, M1, which is CU plus DD plus TD. TD is time deposit. The time deposits means after one point of time only, you can withdraw that money which is deposited in the accounts. So that's called time deposits. TD is a net time deposits of commercial banks. In the commercial banks, after one particular time, when the account will be matured, only that time you can withdraw money. So that will be called as TD, net time deposits of commercial bank. To consider M3, so you have to take M1. M1 is CU plus DD plus TD, which is time deposits by the commercial banks. And finally, you have M4. M4, you have to consider M3. M3, again, it is nothing but M1 plus TD. So to consider that, CU plus DD plus TD plus POPD. So many other concepts covered in this. So you can call it like CU plus DD plus TD plus TOPD. What is TOPD? organization. So this way, finally we get the fourth definition, which is M4. M1, M2, M3 and M4. Finally, we're going to talk about narrow money and the broad money. What is narrow money and what is broad money? The narrow money means the most liquid asset. It will be called as narrow money. So the money which is not much liquid, that will be called as broad money. So in this case, M1 and M2, they both will be called as narrow money because it is most liquid compared to M1, M2, M3, M4. In these four, M1 and M2, they both are most liquid. That's the reason why it is called as narrow money. The liquid in the sense cash in a hand, easily spendable form. Anything it is in the easily spendable form, that's called as a liquid money. So this way, M1 and M2, they both are most liquid among all four. So that's why it is called as a narrow money. At the same time, money, which is a narrow, even we can call it as C plus DD plus OD. C is nothing but CU, currency held by the public. DD is the net demand deposits held by the commercial bank. OD is the deposits which is with the RBI. So it's all considered the liquid form of money. What is there, that will be called as a narrow money. On the other side, you have broad money. The broad money is that the least liquid. Among the four, the least liquid money will be called as broad money. M3, M4, it is called as a broad money. So money which is broad is equal to C, which is the first one, currency held by the public, DD, demand deposits, SD, saving deposits with the post office, TD, which is the time deposits. By considering these all, so that will be called as broad money. So other than this, the M1, M2, M3, M4, how we arrange this? M1 on the basis of the liquidity. Highest liquidity form is M1. So it is called as a, we have given 1, which is M1. The least one is M4 definitely among the four. So that's why we have kept it like a M4. Least liquid, that is compared to all among four. M3 usually we measure, this is the M3, usually we use it for the money supply. The common measurement for the money supply is M3. That is the reason even M3 is also considered as aggregate monetary resources. So thank you so much. If you're really liking my video, please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.